Hello viewers, welcome to lesson 6. In this lesson, you will learn about social welfare administration as a method of social work. This lesson, you will learn social welfare administration is one of the secondary methods of social work. It basically deals with translating the social policies into programs and services, and social welfare administrator functions make the programs more effective. The objectives of this lesson is understand social welfare administration as a method of social work, explain the application of social welfare administration function in social work practice, know the areas of social work where knowledge of social welfare administration can be used and help social workers to work more effectively. The concept of social welfare administration refers to systematic investigation into the problems in the field of social work. It involves the study of the relationship of social workers with their clients, individuals, group, or communities on various levels of interaction or therapy, as well as their natural relationship and functioning within the organizational structure of social agencies. Applications of methods and techniques of social welfare administration in social work practice. Some of the situation or social work practice areas which call for application of social welfare administration methods and techniques, such as planning, organization, coordination, supervision, evaluations are: 1. A social case worker who is interested in obtaining information about the actual or potential effectiveness of the services available in the organization for individuals, couples or families can use social welfare administration methods and techniques. Social welfare administration methods and techniques can be utilized by a social group worker who wishes to assess the extent to which the technique of role play is more or less effective than group discussion in increasing knowledge of drug abuse and among school-going children. A community organizer can use social welfare administration methods and techniques to know the view of community before he or she takes a decision to change the program objectives. A director of special school for mentally retarded children wants to know whether group therapy is as effective as individual therapy in increasing adaptability of mentally retarded children, and an administrator is concerned about effectiveness of the implementation of new program launched. The social welfare administration offers an opportunity for all social workers to make difference in their practice. There is no doubt about the fact that social worker will be more effective practitioner guided by the functions of social welfare administration. Thus, social welfare administration seeks to accomplish the same humanistic goals as does a social work method. Use of various methods of social work. In a study on social welfare administration as a method of social work, you will be interested to know how the primary methods of social work are used in administration. The basic method of social work, such as social casework, social group work, community organization and social actions, etc., play a very important role. Social casework is used with individual beneficiaries in the administration of social services. Social group work is used with families and groups which are at the heart of every society. Social group work is also used in working with neighborhood groups and self-help groups. It is also used to improve the effectiveness of working of the various committees which are part of social welfare administration. Community organization is used in resource mobilization and equitable distribution of services at the community level. It is also used to make effective the functions of Gram Sabhas or wards meeting under Panchayat Raj institutions. Linkages and coordination is also used under social welfare administration. Social action is used in bringing about social welfare strategies and collective action for analyzing, modifying and formulating social welfare policies. It translates the above into the administration. Social work research plays a very important role in social welfare administration. It provides scope for action research, evaluates current programs, and provides social work indicators and statistical indices for developing strategies and programs. It also provides necessary database for e-governance in social work administration. Evaluation is one of the functions of social welfare administration. Knowledge of social welfare administration is useful in evaluating social work programs and practices. It is very much helpful in evaluating the social work programs and practices. It could be a program for individuals, groups, families, community organizations by the agencies. That is, social welfare administration typically focuses on assessment of social work practitioners' work with individual, groups, families, communities, or appraisal of agencies or programs that involve the continued efforts of practitioners with many clients. As such, the evaluation research design, data collection, and analytic strategies have become an integrated component of social service and welfare organizations. Social welfare administration lays special emphasis on evaluation. Some of the evaluation research deals with the assessment of impacts or effects, efficacy and effectiveness, evaluation of agencies and its projects and programs are some of the specialized areas of social welfare administration. Social welfare administration focuses on transformation of organizational goals and policies into program and services using its various principles, methods and techniques, which would be of direct use to the social work professionals and thus would enhance the practice of primary social work methods. It directs itself to select aspects of programs and services, that is, implementation and evaluation, and suggesting modifications. Social welfare administration helps to find ways and means to enhance the quality and standard of social work practices. Nature of social welfare administration. Social welfare administration primarily deals with problems faced by professional social workers, social work agencies, and community in its concern with social work functions. In other words, in social welfare administration, the problems to be investigated are always found in the course of doing social work or planning to do it. Scope of social welfare administration. Identification of social work needs and resources, evaluation of programs and services, evaluation of programs of social work agencies are some of the areas in which principles, methods, and techniques of social welfare administration are undertaken. Social welfare administration is required to know the problems faced by professional social workers in social work agencies and communities in its concern with social work functions. Thus, social welfare administration embraces the entire gamut of social work professions, concepts, theories, methods, programs, services, and the problems faced by social worker in their practice. Social welfare administration is both scientific and professional activity. It promotes social work practice in administration. It administers or implements special programs intended for vulnerable, disadvantaged, and weaker sections of the population, such as women, disabled, children, chronically ill, the aged, scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, etc., through social work processes. It also organizes programs for sustainable social development. It also aims at effective implementation of the regular and special programs of social welfare agencies. Social welfare administration translates social welfare policies and social legislation into social work practice. It administers the resources and personnel available for social work practice. It ventilates the many choices open to clients to adjust themselves as well as to recover themselves from problem situation. Social Welfare Administration also enhances the psychosocial and economic functioning of the clients and beneficiaries. Social Welfare Administration is essential for the effective administration of social service or social welfare services, social security, and social work programs at various levels. It can be used by local self-government, governments, non-governmental organizations, intergovernmental organizations, cooperative societies. The nature of social service requires Social Welfare Administration to act as an essential method of social work practice. Administrative position of social workers who are associated with the provisions of these social services are designated as project directors, officers, administrators, welfare officers, medical social workers, psychiatric social workers, family social workers, school social workers, rehabilitation social workers, community organizers, social workers, etc. In addition, the various fields of social work, such as medical social work in industry, family social work, psychiatric social work, geriatric social work, rural, urban, and tribal development, contain large scope for services which need social work administration. Social Welfare Administration plays an important role in the administration of curative, preventive, promotive, developmental, and statutory social welfare services. Social Welfare Administration is not only needed in the public sector, but it is also largely required in the non-governmental sector, intergovernmental sectors, community-based organizations, and in the cooperative sectors. Public relations. With the increasing role of Social Welfare Administration as a method of social work, one of the components, like public relations, becomes an important function of social welfare agencies. Public relations are a major process of social welfare communication and development support communication. Public relations interpret ideas and information from an agency to its beneficiaries. It also enlists information, ideas, and opinions from the community, beneficiaries, and from the care providers. Such processes lead to harmonious adjustment of an agency with the community. Such an activity also helps to ensure public support to the social welfare agencies and its programs. Understanding conflict resolutions. Knowledge of social work administration helps in understanding conflict resolution. There can be a serious disagreement and argument regarding something important. It can be in the form of a serious difference between two or more beliefs, ideas, interests, programs, which cannot be reconciled. There can be conflict between principles and privileges. Conflict can also be between departments, agencies, organizations, groups and individuals, or vice versa. Sometimes there will be conflict when one party makes some conscious effort to frustrate pursuing the goals or interests of the other party. This is called intergroup conflict. There will be conflict like intra-individual, interpersonal, intergroup, and between organizations. Sometimes conflicts are inevitable and in some cases desirable. The social work administrator should understand the conflict from its very preliminary stage and should take measures to resolve it. Conflict resolutions denotes that solving of the conflict. There are a number of ways to resolve a problem, argument, or difficulty by applying social work methods, techniques, and skills. Management of conflict is very essential. Conflict can be managed as individuals work out differences. The satisfactions of need, cooperations, and success underlie each negotiation. The usual method of conflict resolution is mutual negotiation by individuals, families, groups, or through consensus. Conciliation is another method of conflict resolution in which the settlement is reached in the presence of third party, usually a conciliation officer. Arbitration is yet another method of conflict resolution in which the decision of the arbitrator is binding on the parties. In most of the social work context, the negotiations should continue until it is reconciled, as failure is usually not acceptable. For example, if there can be a conflict between the doctor and the parent regarding a particular treatment for a disabled child, the social worker has to bring in an agreement. The parties and the conciliator must remain calm and considerate and clear about the requirements attained to agreement. Positive climate. Social welfare administrators have a role in and a responsibility for the creation of positive professional relationships with their colleagues. Social welfare administrators are supposed to exercise conscious control over their behavior, and in doing so, they come closer to the realization of good working relationship. When staff members and volunteers work in harmony, there seems to be greater likelihood that the agency will attain its goal and that beneficiaries are and care providers will have good experience together. Working together in harmony, devotion and conviction will lead to meaningful endeavors. Social workers uses conscious self-control over himself or herself all the time. The professional integrity of social worker is based on the understanding that public interest is above self-interest. Professionals constantly strive to develop a sound professional philosophy based on nurturing of values, attitudes, feelings, and responses for creating a positive climate. Positive professional relationship is a feeling of mutual respect, trust, and confidence with one another. It can be experienced rather than measured. For example, when people are warm, friendly, relaxed, open, free with one another, it creates an atmosphere of respect for human being and for human values. Pride in the quality of work done also creates a positive climate. It contributes to success of total enterprise. Persons who are well related to one another seek for an even higher standard of performance. We have to consider that every human being has dignity and worth, strength and weaknesses, and capacity for growth and change. Trustworthiness, responsibility, articulating sound philosophy for personal growth, good channels of communication, etc., ensures positive climate. A positive climate is created when agency procedures and policies are clear. Positive climate is also the result of sharing of work together. Summary. Social welfare administration is one of the secondary methods of social work. It helps social workers to solve problems they confront in administration of social service or social welfare organizations. Social welfare administration offers an opportunity for all social workers to make differences in their practice. Social workers will be more effective practitioners guided by the functions of social welfare administration. Questions. 1. Is social welfare administration a method of social work? 2. Explain how the knowledge of social welfare administration helps social workers in their practice. 3. Social welfare administrators create a positive professional relationship with their colleagues. Comment. 4. What are the situations which call for application of social welfare administration methods and techniques? 5. Knowledge of social work administration helps in understanding conflict resolution. Comment. Social Welfare Administration by D. Paul Chaudhary. It's published by Atmaram and Sons, Delhi. Book of K.D. Gangrade on Development of Voluntary Action, Social Welfare Administration in India, Issues and Challenges, published by Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai. S.L. Goel, Social Welfare Administration, published by Deep and Deep in New Delhi. Ravi Gulati and Kawai Gulati, Strengthening Voluntary Actions in India, published by Konark Publishers, Delhi. Ritu Sarin, The Big Business of NGOs, published in the journal Pioneer. S.H. Pathak, Social Welfare and Evolutionary and Development Perspectives, published by Macmillan, Delhi. Bunkar Rai, book on voluntary agencies and government, Social Welfare Administration in India, Issues and Challenges, published by Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai. Surendra Singh, Encyclopedia of Social Work in India, published by NRBC, Lucknow.